General Ripper, sir.
Group Captain Mandrake speaking.
This is General Ripper speaking.
Yes, sir.
You recognize my voice, Mandrake?
I do, sir. Why do you ask?
Why do you think I ask?
Well, I don't know, sir. We spoke just a few moments ago on the phone, didn't we?
You don't think I'd ask if you recognized my voice unless it was pretty damned important, do you, Mandrake?
No, I don't, sir, no.
All right, let's see if we can stay on the ball. Has the wing confirmed holding at their fail-safe points?
Yes, sir, the confirmations have all just come in.
Very well, now listen to me carefully. The base is being put on condition red. I want this flash to all sections immediately.
Condition red, sir, yes. Jolly good idea, I keep the men on their toes.
Group Captain, I'm afraid this is not an exercise.
Not an exercise, sir.
I shouldn't tell you this, Mandrake, but you're a good officer and you have a right to know. It looks like we're in a shooting war.
Oh, hell.
Mr. President, we are rapidly approaching a moment of truth, both for ourselves as human beings and for the life of our nation. Now, truth is not always a pleasant thing. But it is necessary now to make a choice, to choose between two admittedly regrettable, but nevertheless distinguishable post-war environments. One where you got 20 million people killed, and the other where you got 150 million people killed.
You're talking about mass murder, General, not war.
Mr. President, I'm not saying we wouldn't get our hair mussed, but I do say no more than 10 to 20 million killed, tops, depending on the breaks.
I will not go down in history as the greatest mass murderer since Adolf Hitler.
Perhaps it might be better, Mr. President, if you were more concerned with the American people than with your image in the history books.
General Turgeson, I think I've heard quite sufficient from you. Thank you very much.
Oh, good. Any difficulty?
They say he's having a fit about that squad of MPs.
Yes, well, that can't be helped. Have him brought down here straight away.
Yes, sir.
Is that the Russian ambassador you're talking about?
Yes, it is, General.
Am I to understand the Russian ambassador is to be admitted entrance to the war room?
That is correct. He is here on my orders.
I don't know exactly how to put this, sir, but are you aware of what a serious breach of security that would be? I mean, you'll see everything. You'll see the big board.
That is precisely the idea, General. That is precisely the idea. Staines, get Premier Kissoff on the hotline.
Turgeson, is there really a chance for that plane to get through?
Mr. President, if I may speak freely, the Rusky talks big, but frankly, we think he's short of know-how. I mean, you just can't expect a bunch of ignorant peons to understand a machine like some of our boys. And that's not meant as an insult, Mr. Ambassador. I mean, you take your average Rusky, we all know how much guts he's got. Hell, look at all of them Nazis killed off, and they still wouldn't quit.
Can't you stick to the point, General?
Well, if the pilot's good, see? I mean, if he's really sharp, he can barrel that baby in solo. I mean, you ought to see it sometime. It's a sight. A big plane, like a 52 room. It's jet exhaust, frying chickens in the barnyard.
Yeah, but has he got a chance?
Has he got a chance? Hell, yeah.
Stop!
He's... hang on a second, Dimitri. He says their air defense now only claims 3 aircraft confirmed. The 4th may only be damaged.
Mr. President, I'm beginning to smell a big fat commie.
Hey, what about Major Kong?
President, I would not rule out the chance to preserve a nucleus of human specimens.
Look at this from a military point of view. I mean, supposing the Ruskies stashed away some big bomb, see, and we didn't. When they come out in 100 years, they could take over.
I agree, Mr. President. In fact, they might even try an immediate sneak attack so they could take over our mineshaft space.
Yeah, I think it'd be extremely naive of us, Mr. President, to imagine that these new developments are going to cause any change in Soviet expansionist policy. I mean, we must be increasingly on the alert to prevent them from taking over other mineshaft space in order to breed more prodigiously than we do, thus knocking us out through superior numbers when we emerge. Mr. President, we must not allow a mineshaft gap.
Sir, I have a plan. Monsieur, I can walk.
We'll meet again. Don't know where. Don't know where. But I know we'll meet again some sunny day. I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go,